Hello and welcome to Behind the Science, where we ask challenging questions directly to the scientists who are trying to solve today's toughest problems. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. I'm finally ready to graduate from analytical scale to preparative scale chromatography, but I have to tell you, I have no idea where to start. So in this episode of Behind the Science, let's look to see if there are resources that can help bridge this gap between analytical and prep. Hi, Steve.
Hey, Jen.
I knew I'd find you in the purification lab.
Yeah.
And that's perfect because I finally have my analytical method solid and I'm ready to scale up to prep.
Oh, now wait a minute. Now don't start right there. You need to kind of figure out what your goals are.
Well, really, I think my goal is to take my analytical method and match it exactly to the prep method.
Well, that's it. I mean, you need to actually go with exactly the same chemistry in both your analytical and your preparative column. It's kind of a pairing. It's kind of a thing of like wine and cheese.
But no eating in the lab. Could you show me an example of this?
Well, let's go take a look.
Great.
In this example, we have scaled up the Acuity BEH C18 1.7 micron column to an X-Bridge C18 5 micron prep column. The resolution between peaks can be maintained by selecting analytical and prep columns with the same L over DP, that's length divided by particle size, and maintaining the same optimal linear velocities of 1.7 and 5 micron columns.
That is a nice pairing, Steve, but did you notice the time? You took my beautiful 5-minute method and now it's over 40 minutes long. Is there any way to do this faster and get better resolution?
Well, there are some tricks that we can use. Let's take a look. Here, the top example is a standard linear gradient where we start our reverse phase LC gradient at low percentage organic and move to a high percentage organic. This can provide longer run times as we've seen. The trick is to get this shorter. In example two, this is a set of narrower linear gradients where we start off at higher organic. Alternatively, we can use a focus gradient. The gradient starts at the same low percentage as in our traditional linear gradient. However, the first segment has a steep rise. Next, the shallow gradient segment is defined by the elution percentage of our target compound. And the final segment ramps up quickly to the final organic percentage of the original method. A real example shown here is where we compare a traditional linear gradient to a focus gradient. We achieve several benefits. Increased resolution, shorter prep run times, therefore increased throughput, and have reduced the amount of mobile phase, which leads to lower cost.
Steve, thank you for that very educational overview. I think I'm now ready to go from my analytical scale chromatography to my prep chromatography.
Well, Jen, hey, we're just scratching the surface, but first we've got to make sure we remember to actually match up the wine and the cheese. We got to match the column. We're just getting started.
Thank you, Steve. I feel much more confident now going from analytical to prep. But as Steve said, there's still so much to learn to ensure I'm successful. One of the coolest things he showed me was this online prep calculator. Definitely need to check that out. Very useful. And check out the links below to gain access to all the resources we mentioned and more, such as seminars, wall charts, and be sure to contact a Waters representative for more in-depth training. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science.